The Orochi Group and Ricky Pagan, arch enemies for life. They are the Joker to Ricky Pagan's Batman. I am the Knight. They are the windmills that turn into radioactive ogres. And Ricky Pagan is not afraid to tilt. But times, they are a-changing, Kimosabe. The big boom-boom makes for strange bedfellows, and Ricky Pagan appreciates the strange. Now the filthy disease has got this city all bugaboo. The Orochi cadets, what little is left of them, are the main force fighting back the Black Tide. Ricky Pagan is a big man, big enough to bury the hatchet. Carrying grudges is like drinking poison and hoping someone else dies. It's bad for the mojo. The enemy of my enemy can be all kinds of groovy in the desperate hour. It's crisis time, and we are all the solution. And so Ricky Pagan gives you his bike. I don't think you grasp the gravity, Kimosabe. This is Ricky Pagan's bike. This is his roaring chrome steed. A troubadour couldn't sing to you all the acts of derry-do and holy debauchery that have taken place on this machine. Ricky Pagan is trusting you with his baby. Ricky Pagan needs you for a special mission. To deliver the supplies to the Orochi still holding out against the monsters. Ricky Pagan is trusting you to bring his steed back intact. Smile, friend. This is the fun part.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Babies are born without kneecaps. They don't get them until they are 2 to 6 years old.
Come on, come on, come on! Frag! Frag! Get some! Yeah, get some! Come at me, bro, I'm jacked! Yeah, yeah, you nargle puke dorks! Give me all of your aggro! Pop, 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 pow! I'll put a megaton of hot plasma right up your... Oh! I was just, gaming. You know, gaming. I'm a gamer. It's what I do.
She's a hacker, too. Ram's semi-famous in some online circles.
Well, I don't want to brag, but... I've gotten into a slew of systems. I graduated from corporations to governments when I was only little. I found the secret way into occult eBay. And you should see the hidden files Morning Light has on you. That's how I recognized you. But my favoriteest thing is needling Orochi. I've spent months setting up web traces, backdoors, dummy accounts, and password spammers from every angle. Ba-joom! But at every angle, their walls held up. That is, until 3 weeks ago. See? Orochi is planning...
All made of stars. Made of stars. You're all made of stars. Marco. Bolo. Marco. Dream a little dream with me.
John!
グラウンドゼロだ。ゼロポイントシグナルだ。やばい。消してくれ、ラム。おい、グズグズするな。家まで飛んで帰るぞ。吸血以下の汚染が頻繁に起こってる。耳を通り抜けていく。俺たちの耳の中。
No, he's just misunderstood. I've been talking with him. John? You're getting kind of icky.Can you stop that? Please! That was spooky, right? Right, Orochi. Recently, they started setting up some kind of fancy satellite uplink on the roof of an apartment complex, very close to here. I've got a little gizmo.If you attach it to that uplink, I can tap their data stream remotely. Imagine all that yummy, yummy data! You have to get on that roof without being seen by the Orochi cyborg units. Good luck! Not that you... Oh, Mother Hubbard! You sneaks! Thought you could get the drop on the Neuromancer Queen, ha! Get some! Oh, this? This is just a new mech game I play. Yeah!A hyper-realistic mech game with emergent physics. Yeah.
Mr. Modularizing is an anagram for Jim Morrison.
Thank you. is authorized. Please be still. You will die back, or we shall be forced to cancel your life. You are not authorized. You are not authorized. Lethal force is authorized. Please be still. You will die back, or we shall be forced to cancel your life.
Halt, human. This unit is designated Security 5. This unit has crucial data that... Wait! Is that my voice? Is that my voice? This does not compute. Danger! Danger, Will Robinson! Dead or alive, you're coming with me! Classic. This unit is an ally. This unit has crucial data to share. The virulent substance, designated the Filth, has spread to multiple tiers of technology within Tokyo. The Filth corrupts the programming of said technology to malevolent ends. Nothing is safe. This unit would like to investigate further. However, this unit cannot leave its position at this time. Perhaps you can find uncorrupted mech units and bring the reinforcements here. This device may be used to take remote control of uncorrupted units. This unit wishes you luck. This unit greets you. This unit is approached by a flesh and bone entity. Halt! Scanning for filth corruption. Full anatomy scan, level 7. Scan complete. Life form is biological. Life form is... Your bone mass is at acceptable massiness. Your cellular levels are... That is, your protein count is... Scan confirms you're one of the good guys. Anyway, this unit is curious about the Orochimaru cyborgs. The cyborgs were the first technological units corrupted by the filth. The filth then evolved to corrupt other forms of technology. But why were the cyborgs first? This unit suspects the cyborgs contain the key to further knowledge. What is their nature? Are they mostly robotics containing some meat? Or are they organisms covered in some metal? Ugh, like walking cans of meat. Robo-spam. Ugh, that's totes gross. That is to say, the process of constructing such units may be highly unsanitary. Incoming data. A nearby hospital made many deliveries to the downtown Valley building in the months preceding the filth explosion. This unit hypothesizes a connection to the cyborgs. Using a GPS connection, this unit has pinpointed the last location of the delivery ambulance. This unit hypothesizes that we will find more data there. This unit thinks the two of us should go check that out. Like, now. For serious.
Lethal force is authorized. Please be
still. The signal is coming from the highway. Perhaps the ambulance was up there when the bridges of Kaidan were bombed. This unit is certain that this obstacle is not insurmountable.
Thank you.
Valley building is nearby.
You will die back, or we shall be forced to cancel your life.
Very good. This unit suspects it is too large to enter the autopsy. This unit will help you. Does not compute. Target locked. Target locked. Initiating frag target protocol.
Thank you.
does not compute. Scanning. Target locked. Initiating frag target protocol. Domo arigato, domo.
Access denied. Identification required. Identification accepted. Access granted.
Spider senses set to level venti caffeination. The schematics this unit has access for this building indicate that this is where the organs and bodies brought from the hospital are delivered. Domo arigato, domo. Domo arigato, domo. Spider senses set to level venti caffeination. This unit fears that the population in cold storage has responded to you opening the door. Please follow this unit. Shiz just got real! That is, you must escape. This unit will hold them here. Get out before they can kill you! Think I could come back? Consciousness skips between machines. I just moved to a new body. Perhaps you're thinking about this whole immortality thing from the wrong angle. Just a thought.
Terror is not about sweating, screaming, or running. Those things are incidental. Terror, real terror, is having all of our illusions, all the ways we like to present ourselves to the world, torn down. We have no choice but to see the naked truth of ourselves. No one ever likes what they see. Are you brave enough to examine yourself that closely, I wonder? There is a shared space of thought between humanity, the collective unconscious. It is not theoretical. I have been there. It is a metaphor, true, but it is a place where metaphors can cut. In that place, there is a shape-shifting pantheon of thought patterns, the Jungian archetypes. One of those archetypes is the shadow. It dwells in the collective unconscious, and it dwells in each of us. We do not like to acknowledge it, and that makes it angry sometimes. Carl Jung codified this pantheon of archetypes. They serve as the many aspects of ourselves. Confronting them can increase our capacity for psychological growth. In your memories, I see a series of choices. Do you understand the ramification of those choices, I wonder? I offer you a chance to explore your past. I can take you to a place where archetypes walk and metaphors become solid geometry. I suspect that you need to confront your shadow. No thanks required. To defeat one's enemies, one must know the self. You must have read that somewhere. The archetypes might wear familiar faces, but they are all pieces of you. Every choice is a door. I mislike opening adult doors. Messy, messy creatures. Every growing mind needs a guide. Our parents, biological or surrogate, are there as observational lessons to teach us right from wrong and the consequences of a life lived poorly. Not all people have this advantage. Sometimes, accidents happen. Did you leave your parents behind, or did they leave you? You had no one to watch over you. Perhaps you took slivers of mentorship from those you met along the way. A difficult road to navigate. But perhaps it was easier to dive into the secret world with so few attachments behind you. Often we are defined by those around us. Did you define yourself by the presence of your friends, or by their absence? Focus on the good times. Focus on the bad. See their faces. Hear their voices. They were the pantheon of your past. When you left your mundane life so abruptly, there were casualties. A partner or romance that you left behind, perhaps. Or simply desires that you discarded for your new existence. This is understandable. To achieve individuation, you must remember them and choose. Focus now on the object of your affection. Her voice, her presence. Let the memory surface. Children. The biological imperative. Did you sire offspring? Did you choose to have no children? Or was that the hand that was dealt to you? Is parenthood something you saw in a hypothetical future? Think back. The shadow aspect. The archetype is built out of the mad science medley of the traits your ego hides from itself. A sleight of hand show for an audience of one. This is the portion of you hidden in the unconscious. The part of the iceberg below the water. Focus. Let it rise. Let it manifest. Interesting. What do you think it says about you that you gave your shadow that form?
Yeah.
Sometimes we feel small and insubstantial. Just look into the mirror and remember all of those different people you have been. All of those different stages of development. Every choice created a new you. So many yous. You are still all of those people. You have access to all of their gifts and flaws. We are all of us, a legion of archetypes unto ourselves. We are a multitude. We have so many dimensions. We are never truly alone.